Yes, I'm ready to be ready to be ready to be ready to be ready.
So we used to say that a lot, getting ready to be ready to be ready to be ready. And that we'd just like to say, I'm ready. Because ready to be ready to be ready to be ready to be ready feeds your appetite to get to where you really want to go.
I'm ready.
We want you to just be as ready as you are and happy about how ready you are, because that's how your inner being feels. Your inner being feels really good about how ready you are. How ready you are. How ready you are. Where you are is just right. And you know why? Where you are is enough. You know why? Because you can't attract beyond where you are. So it's got to be enough. Do you get that? It's got to be okay where you are, because you can't be other than where you are. And because your inner being is never judging you about being in a wrong place. So when you're unhappy about where you are, you know what the problem is? You're crossways of your inner being, who never ever says you're not where you're supposed to be. Do you get that? Here's another piece to this. You're right here where you can hear this, because we can feel you. You've come right along, because we've been talking about what you already know, and then we talk about what you already know. So you're right up to speed. Every one of you, you are knowing what we are knowing right now about this. So let's take it just one step further so that you can really feel benefit moving forward out of this day. A friend earlier talked about there's this perspective and this perspective and this perspective, and we teased and we said there are endless perspectives. So let's talk about some perspectives here. Just a really clean, clear, easy way for you to approach this moment in time, this moment in time, this moment in time. You can be observing or considering a condition or an outcome, like a person, a bank account number, the condition of your house or relationship. You can be considering that aspect of life. And it's logical to be in a physical human body with your senses that you would do that. You can also be considering your vibrational relationship with your inner being right now. So if you start getting in the habit of tending to your vibrational reality rather than your manifested reality, can you feel the difference? Let's say that you hear a funny sound in your car and you worry that it's getting ready to break down. So you're focused upon a condition that you're having a response to. Naturally, you would. But let's say that rather than responding to conditions and letting the condition evoke your emotional response, let's say you've decided to get out ahead of everything and you've decided to take charge of your emotional response. So you're looking at your emotional response rather than letting your emotional response be a knee-jerk reaction to a condition. Can you hear this? So you hear the funny knock, knock, knock in your car, and you start to feel a soft wafting of insecurity coming over you, but you don't let it take hold. Instead, you say, I have really good timing in my life and I can take care of this. You say, things always work out for me. You could even say, this has been a really stable vehicle. You could even say, everything works out well for me. You could even say, all is well here. You could say, there's nothing serious going on here. You could say, I am stable, I'm secure. And our point is that if you will stay there and focus there until you really feel that, till you really feel that, then the outcome will please you. We've said to Jerry and Esther, as they were moving around in their monster buses, and even all of this lovely merry band that gets on airplanes and in the van that hauls all the equipment, they're moving around a lot from place to place to place to place to rendezvous with you, and they always get there. They always get there, and everything always turns out wonderful. And it isn't that there are not things that they have to deal with, but things always do turn out. And when you decide to know that, and you decide to acknowledge that, and you decide to let that be the dominant vibration that you're offering, then the current condition becomes less and less of a significant factor in your life experience. And that is such an important thing for this reason. Do you know what the predominant culprit, which is a hindrance to you getting what you want, is? Do you know what the culprit or the hindrance to the more that you're asking for? Do you know what it is? It's what is. Because what is in a state of becoming more all the time. And if you are fascinated and so verbal about describing what is, then you're not allowing the universe to yield to you the new improved version that you've already asked for. So what step five really is standing in this place of understanding that it's always going to be changing and it's always going to be more, and that the vibrational version is always an improved version of what is. And if you can not be so enamored with what is and so verbal about what is and so interested in getting everybody else to agree with you about what is, and you can be more emotional based where you care about how you feel first and foremost, so that you're giving yourself and others the benefit of the doubt, so you're looking for the positive aspects in things, so you're reaching for the thought that feels better, what begins to happen is you just feel good and 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 feel good, feel good and feel good. This can take a while, and feel good and feel good and feel good. And others look at you and they say, why do you feel so good all the time? And you say, because I decided to. And that twists their brain into a knot. What do you mean? I've decided to feel good too, but something went wrong with my car and I had a fight with my lover, and you say, oh, I'm way past that. I don't let the details of my current life mess up where I'm going. This is a really good time for a segment of refreshment.